This star is making headlines across the globe. It's a red supergiant that's not just enormous, it's on the brink of explosion. And we've just captured it close up like never before. This is WOH G64. It's one of the largest stars we've ever discovered. It's nestled in the Large Magellanic Cloud, a satellite galaxy of the Milky Way around 160,000 light years away. That makes this image of WOH G64 the first ever detailed image of a star outside our galaxy. Imagine that, a star so far away, yet now we can see it in unprecedented detail thanks to cutting-edge technology at the VLTI in Chile. Using the gravity instrument, astronomers have revealed new information about this dying giant that could change how we understand the life and death of massive stars. And here's the most exciting part. WOH G64 is nearing the end of its life. It's expected to explode in one of the most powerful events in the universe, a supernova. So what makes WOH G64 so special, and how does this discovery bring us closer to understanding the most massive stars in the universe? Let's dive in. WOH G64 belongs to an exclusive club of stars known as red supergiants. These are evolved stars that have burned through all the hydrogen fuel in their cores, and what's left is a star that's now fusing heavier elements, causing it to expand to incredible sizes while teetering on the brink of collapse. On average, 0.0001% of stars in the universe are likely to be red supergiant stars right now. And WOH G64 is a true cosmic heavyweight at 2,000 times larger than our sun. That's so big that if we replace the sun with this star, it would reach the orbit of Saturn. That makes it the largest known star with a well-defined radius, because yes, there is Stevenson 2-18 with an estimated radius of 2,150 times the radius of the sun, but this measurement is unreliable and it's likely not even a member of the cluster that we think it's part of, which would affect its radius, and meaning it's likely actually smaller than that. Anyway, moving on. Now, because of their size, red supergiants are incredibly luminous. They emit a lot of light. And WOH G64 is no different, shining with a brightness of up to 500,000 times that of the sun. But here's where it gets interesting. Recent observations suggest that WOH G64 might be dimming. Could this be a sign of its final act before it goes supernova? Or is there something else at play? These are the mysteries that keep us astronomers on our toes. And this big ring around WOH G64 is thanks to its shedding material creating a dusty cocoon surrounding the star. And it's not just a static shell, it's a dynamic, evolving structure shaped by the influence of the dying star. Using a very large telescope interferometer, astronomers have captured these stunning close-up images, revealing the star's dusty surroundings in amazing detail. But there is a twist. Instead of the dust shell being spherical in shape, which is what scientists expect, they found it was elongated, which raises more questions than answers. So let's talk more about this cocoon of dust surrounding WOH G64. This dust envelope is a common feature for red supergiants nearing the end of their lives. They form as the star sheds its outer layers, releasing material rich in elements like silicon and oxygen. But what sets WOH G64 apart is its unexpected shape. Previously, astronomers thought it would have more of a spherical dust cocoon, but this new data has revealed it has more of an elongated shape, which has us asking, what's causing this elongation? One possibility is a bipolar outflow. Picture jets of material erupting from the star's poles, sculpting the dust into this elongated shape. Supporting this idea are observations of OH maser emissions, which often indicate the existence of these kinds of outflows. But another intriguing idea involves a potential for a hidden companion star. If WOH G64 has a partner, the gravitational influence of that star could distort WOH G64's dust envelope, creating this elongated shape that we now see. But without direct evidence of a companion, this remains more of a tantalizing hypothesis. To solve this mystery, astronomers are turning to future observations. The upgraded Gravity Plus instrument promises even sharper images, while additional mid-infrared data could provide critical details about the dust's composition and structure. Who knows, maybe JWST can check it out. But each new observation brings us closer to understanding the true nature of this dust cocoon. And what's awesome about WOH G64 is that it's far from a static object. This star is evolving before our very eyes. Over the past decade, astronomers have observed it dimming, which is often a telltale sign of the end times for a red supergiant star. And a key driver of this dimming is mass loss. Like other red supergiants, WOH G64 loses enormous amounts of material through powerful stellar winds. To put it into perspective, this star sheds an amount of material roughly equivalent to the mass of Earth every single month. And this process forms this circumstellar dust envelope we discussed earlier. But how does this material actually escape the star's gravity? Well, one factor is stellar pulsations, the rhythmic expansion and contraction of WOH G64's outer layers as the star becomes more and more unstable. And these pulsations grow stronger and slower as the star ages, weakening the gravitational hold on its surface, making it easier for material to escape into space. This ongoing mass loss is directly linked to WOH G64's dimming. As more dust pools around the star, it absorbs more and more of the star's light, especially at those near-infrared wavelengths. To better understand WOH G64, we can compare it to similar red supergiants in our galaxy, such as VY Canis Majoris. While these stars share traits like extreme mass loss and dust formation, differences in their environment, like metallicity, offers valuable insights into how these processes vary across the universe. So what's next for WOH G64? This dynamic system is inching closer to its inevitable fate, a spectacular supernova. And while the exact timeline of this event is difficult to pin down, each observation helps us piece together the story of its final chapters. Future observations with advanced tools like Gravity Plus will allow us to monitor these changes closely. And one day, perhaps centuries or millennia, although I sure hope it's sooner, we will see it end its journey as a supernova, enriching its stellar neighborhood with heavy elements and leaving behind a legacy that will fuel the birth of new stars and planets. As always, thank you for joining me. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more deep dives into the universe's most fascinating phenomena. Until next time, stay curious and keep looking up.